Welcome to the recorded service of the First Baptist Church, Hingham, Massachusetts, on Sunday, March 19th, 2023. Our call to worship is taken from the book of Philippians. As this passage is read, may we open our hearts to its message as we open our mouths in praise and prayer, and as united together in worship through the presence of the Holy Spirit. The Apostle Paul is writing to the church in Philippi. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in the knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God. Come, let us worship the Lord.
For the leaders of our nations around the world,
to turn to you and to recognize your truth and to be guided with decisions that reflect justice. We commit this into your hands, Lord.
Hear our prayer.
And for the light that shines brightly, especially the light that shines brightly in the midst of darkness, for the hope that is sustained, may you stir the light of Christ in our lives. May you stir hope so that as we look at our world, we do not become dismayed, but rather we come to a deeper understanding that truly all things can and do work together for good for those who love the Lord. Therefore, we seek to love you as we invite others to join in this love of transforming power across our world. Lord,
hear our prayer.
With praise and thanksgiving, we present our petitions to you. We have answered prayers. The first prayer was an answer of, it was time for Joan's father to be called home. It is an answered prayer. He fought the good fight. He tried procedures right up to the days before you called him home. And yet, this was his time. And so we celebrate his faith. We celebrate the opportunity to be able to support this family as we pray for healing grief. Lord,
hear our prayer.
We celebrate that Sandy, an active member of this church, has received a clear diagnosis and that plans are underway for medical treatment for both of the primary concerns. We ask for wisdom. We ask for strength and for healing for the journey. Lord,
hear our prayer.
We celebrate Paula's new great-grandbaby, Luca Richard, healthy and well, a gift to his parents, the family, and all who know him. Together we
praise God.
We celebrate Marion in our midst. The anticipation with great joy of the birthday celebration this next Saturday. We ask your blessing. We ask that you be with Marion leading up to this day in a very special way as friends and family gather to celebrate 100 years. Together we
praise God.
We now continue faithfully and persistently to lift up individuals that we know by name. We are reminded always that you know them by name. You know their deepest concerns. You know their medical challenges, the diseases that are being treated, or at times that are no longer being treated because of the journey they're on. And so we commit each of these individuals as we speak their name into your care, and that they would know experientially your love and that they are being carried in your arms. Therefore, we commit to you the following: Barry, Marley, Tyler, Jen, Dottie, and the early journey with hospice care, Barbara S., Carol, Nancy M., Teddy, RJ, Jacob, Xavier, Courtney, as well as Elaine's family for continued healing grief. Lord, and as we present our personal prayers and the prayers of the church family, we now unite our voices as we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples when we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
Today's lesson is from John chapter 15, verses 5 through 8. Hear the reading of God's word. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me, and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. May the Lord add his blessing to this, the reading of Scripture.